Hey folks, today it's all about improving sounds synthetically, or to be more precise, layering sinus waves under existing sounds. If I worked at Waves maybe in the marketing department, I could talk about artificial enhancement or something similar, but I don't. In today's example, I would like to explain this by using a bass drum that needs a bit more low end, like this one. Normally, you would probably use an EQ and make the frequencies louder, like the EQ2, and push some deeper frequencies. Or maybe you could use a drum synthesizer and just layer your drum synth underneath your kick drum sample. But today we want to make something unusual and we want to use an unusual Bitwig device, which is called Tree Monster. And this one is basically one frequency follower combined with the sine wave generator and the ring modulator. And we don't need the ring modulator just yet, so we can turn it all the way down. And we turn the mix knob all the way down. And then we start to narrow our frequency window down to the kick drum, which is of course starting maybe at around 30 Hertz to maybe 100 Hertz. Okay. And then we choose a threshold curve, our threshold value. This might be okay. And then we bring in the mix. This sounds okay. With the speed knob, we can choose how fast the analyzer or the frequency analyzer reacts to our input signal. So we can kind of interpolate between the frequency steps in the incoming input signal. Which results in a more rounded sine wave or frequency pitch envelope. You have to play around a bit with all values to find a sweet spot, but you can already hear. We just created some nice low end on this kick drum. This method, of course, works also on drum loops. So add one Tree Monster device here. And then, of course, we start to narrow down our frequency analyzer window to the kick drum range. So this is basically the window in which our frequency follower works. And then turn the ring modulator down. As you can see, it's a very nice and easy way to add low end to sounds, because the frequency follower kind of detects your pitch and your pitch envelope of the sound. And of course, the frequency follower does not always work 100% correct, so try it out for yourself. Another example I want to show you is again on this track here with the rimshot. Because you also can add sine waves to higher pitched sounds. And it can be very interesting. So we just added one sine wave, one octave below the rim shot, or kind of try to. As you can see, you can also use this method for atonal sounds, which then becomes pitch sounds in the end, which again can lead to nice and interesting results. And it shows that the Tree Monster device is actually a very helpful device in the daily workflow. So it's not just for weird and strange sounds. You can use it for bass drums too. So that's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Leave me a like, subscribe to the channel, and thanks to my Patreons. Until next time, see you and bye.